Oke, selamat malam semuanya. Malam ini kita akan memulai sesi Zoom perdana kita. Jadi semoga bermanfaat untuk kita semua. Malam hari ini, terima kasih teman-teman semua yang bisa join. Dan ada satu teman juga dari luar yang join malam hari ini. Jadi mari kita mulai. So the first thing first, so let's introduce ourselves. So as I already told you guys, you have to just give me your short name, so because maybe we will see more again in the future. So just a short name and then what your activity. I think that's all right. So that's enough. So just so we know how to call each other. And then maybe just a little bit of your activity, maybe your job or your activity right now. Oke, kita perkenalan dulu ya. Oke, mungkin mulai dari saya. Oke.
So I start.
You want to start?
No, I don't mind.
Oke. Let me start because I'm
Anybody
the host.
Can...
I'm the host. So yes, I should start first. So, but I think everybody already knows me. So that is
dari kecil.
Reintroduce.
Okay.
Reintroduce yourself.
Nama saya Roberto, tapi saya biasa kalau di channel pakainya nama Obet. Kalau teman-teman semua panggilnya Beto. Jadi it's just a little change in the letter. So you can call me Obet or or Beto. Or Robert or Rob, so yeah, you can have a lot of choices, more than one choice. And then I am a teacher actually. I'm teaching math. Okay, I'm a teacher for primary school. Jadi saya guru sekolah dasar dan mengajar matematika. Okay, I think that's enough from me. Okay, so call me Obet or Beto. That's it. Okay?
Rob.
Okay. Or Rob. Yes, Rob or Robert. Yeah, okay. You have four choices. So take anyone you like. Okay, so now... okay, you can start, Alex.
I'm Alex. I am from Russia. I am English and Russian teacher.
Oke, udah jelas semuanya.
Di Rusia, aku guru bahasa Inggris, bahasa Rusia. Something like that.
Oke, jadi ada guru beneran aku di sini loh. So we have like English teacher. Iya, kalau mau belajar bahasa Rusia juga boleh. Sebenarnya tahunya ada yang tahu.
If you want to learn Russian, it's okay too.
I just know like prefat, hello.
No, there are some other words like apteka. It's from Dutch, yeah. In Russian, we use apteka.
Okay. Apsteka?
Apotek, apteka.
No. The word hello.
Ah, hello, privet.
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 Privet. Okay, itu halo tuh bad. Bahasa Rusianya halo. Ini kita kayaknya kelam ini ya. Seharusnya cuma 5 menit nih. Okay, Alex dan dia guru bahasa Inggris dan bahasa Rusia. Okay, next. Siapa nih mau duluan? Oci atau Pikan?
Kak Oci first.
Oke.
Okay.
Kak Oci.
Okay. Tua banget gue. Okay, my name is Troisha Sarja. You can call me Oci. Kerja sebagai pegawai swasta. Tolong di bahasa Inggris kan?
Just an
employee.
An employee.
I'm an employee in one of company in Jakarta.
Okay, so
okay, I think that's it.
A company worker, okay, and an employee. Worker, yes. So Ochi, you can call her Ochi.
Oh, Ochi means eyes, yes, in old Russian.
artinya S di bahasa Rusia.
Iya,
yang lama. Nggak tahu, mungkin fair kayak bahasa Sanskerta-nya kali ya.
Lama amat arti nama gue.
You say old Russian? What was that supposed to mean, old Russian? So it's like...
It's like outdated word. It's not used.
So how about the
some song.
Oh, okay. So the current word for ice in Russia?
Different.
Oh, different. Oh, oke, okay. Iya kan? Ya kayak bahasa tua ya.
Kayak
bahasa sastra kali ya, bahasa sastra ya. Jadi, ya, kita juga ada
this,
kan.
Puitis banget, puitis, bahasa puitis gitu. All this word.
Maybe in Ukrainian, they use it. It's like...
Oh, oke. Okay. Okay. In Ukraine.
Di sana mungkin masih pakai bahasa-bahasa sastra seperti itu. Nih, oke, okay, si Ani baru join. Oke, okay. Thank you. Terima kasih, Ochi. Oke, okay. Pinka, next.
Oke.
Okay. Hello. I would like to introduce myself. My name is Pinka Melita Deborah, or you can call me Pinkan. I'm 25 years old, and I work as business development manager at financial technology company. My hobby is reading a book and traveling, but during this pandemic, I can go anywhere, so cooking is my new hobby right now.
Wow. Thank you. Don't go anywhere where. Okay. Don't go anywhere where.
So we can call you what? Pinkan, right?
Yes, please.
Pinkan.
Pinkan. Okay. So Pinkan. So yes. So you are the business development manager in one fintech company.
Yes.
Okay. Cool. So Ochi, Pinkan. Okay. Next, siapa nih? Duma atau Ani mau?
Aku, Kak.
Oke. Okay. Ya, yeah. Itu ya masih kelihatan mukanya ya. Itu pakai masker juga lagi.
Gelap kah soalnya di sini? Lagi rame juga.
Iya, yeah, iya, yeah, iya. Yeah. No, I mean like foto profilnya udah pakai masker juga, jadi kita agak menerka-nerka nih si Alex mukanya kayak gimana. Oke. Okay. Oke, okay, ya silakan Duma.
My name is Dumaria Sultama. You can call me Duma. Mm-hmm. Sekarang cuman jadi apa? Mahasiswa. Terus yeah, lagi nyoba jadi guru sekolah minggu.
Oke.
Okay. Ada, Kak.
Oke, okay, so Duma and then she's student. Tingkat berapa Duma?
Lagi mau mahasiswa, Kak. Lagi nyoba.
Oke. Jadi so still new to as a student.
Like university student.
Yes, just graduate from high school. Is it? Yeah, and around that, right? Baru mau. Ya, yeah, atau mahasiswa S2 atau S3 gitu jangan.
Baru selesai high
school. Yes. So, yeah. So it's not like grad school or postdoctoral school, no. So they are like young people, Alex. So yeah. So yeah. Okay, Duma is the next one. Okay, terakhir Ani boleh. Okay, Ani silakan.
Hello, my name is Apriani Panjaitan. Mm-hmm. I'm grade 12 social science.
Okay. And what? Mau kasih tahu hobinya? My hobby is?
My hobby is swimming.
Swimming, okay. Okay. Tadi dipanggilnya apa?
Ani, A-N-I.
A-N-I, so Ani. So it's not A-N-I, it's Ani. You can say the word, right, Alex? So Ani, yeah. She is still student in grade 12. So high school, right? The last year. Yeah. So next year, this June, I think she will graduate. So yeah. So okay. So Ochi, Pinkan, Duma, Ani. So Alex and Obed. Saya pakai nama panggungnya Obed, maaf ya guys. Jadi kalau kalian nggak biasa, tapi nggak apa-apa, kalian panggil saya Kabet.
Nama panggung, Bo.
It's okay, just be yourself.
Nama panggung maksudnya gini, di video-video saya, di video-video dari 2 tahun lalu, pakai itu aja lah. Pakai nickname.
Nickname.
Iya, nickname-nya itu. Jadi, ya. Oke. Okay. Sudah selesai. Introduction-nya, jadi kita mau mungkin ini seperti saya bilang fleksibel, jadi mungkin biar nggak terlalu makan waktu, jadi kita langsung mulai aja dari tadi pertanyaan pertama Alex. So we're done with the introduction, so let's start with the activity. Jadi we can start with just a free talk, and then since Alex already asked us question. Tadi ada yang denger gak Alex nanya apa?
How often we go to church, right?
Yeah, so jadi saya udah kasih tahu Alex, kalian teman-teman saya dari gereja, jadi udah tahu. And then that was the first question from Alex. So how often do we go to church in a week? Ada yang mau coba jawab?
Me.
Okay, so Pinkan will answer your question, Alex. Yes, please. Okay.
In a week, maybe I can go to church like 3 times in a week, or 4 times, because we have many services. Events services. And services too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, mungkin mau dijabarin lagi hari apa aja, Pink?
Okay.
Jabarin.
We have
at least the days, right? You just mentioned the days.
Okay.
Sunday.
First day. First day at Monday. We have praying service. We have praying together. Just for 2 hours, and after that, at Friday we have practices with song and music. And Saturday we have like even for youth or teenagers at our church and community like that. And on Sunday, we get together to going to church like everybody does.
Thank you.
Okay, so Pinkan is like one of the one activist. Like she's very very busy. So like she said, so can be four time. Not can be. I think that's every week four like time. That. So yeah, not can be like every week. So Sunday is obvious, right? Sunday is like the big service day. It's like
Sunday is a must.
Sunday is a must. So and then Monday is like for prayer. So maybe just
other days are optional.
Yeah. Yes, optional.
Yes.
And then for the so we do like practice or like preparation for the Sunday service. So we usually do the preparations like for the songs and the music. So we do the preparation on Thursday, right? Friday
night.
Friday night. Thursdays. Yeah. So that's why we choose Thursday this week, because tomorrow everybody will
tomorrow be is practice.
Yeah. So Friday and then Saturday also for the youth service. So can be 4 times. Mungkin yang lain ada mau jawab? So that is Pinkan, right? So she can go to church like up to 4 times in a week.
4 times.
Yang lain gimana? Kalau Oci berapa kali seminggu?
I think the same.
The same.
But three or four times.
Okay. So Oci also the same. So 3 or 4 times. Kalau Ani sama Duma, mungkin 2 kali ya. atau 5 kali. Ada mau jawab Ani, Duma, satu minggu kalian pergi ke gereja berapa kali? Try to answer.
Aku 2 kali, Kak.
Oke. Okay. Oci kenapa tuh?
Oh, your friend is lost signal, I think.
Oke, okay, so ya yeah, just oke, okay, just wait. Oke, okay, kalau okay. Ani like 2 times. So Duma, kalau Duma?
Duma. Cuma 2 times.
Sama ya. At least youth service sama Sunday service ya. Oke, okay, ya. Yeah, so yeah, we are kind of like very active. Oke, okay. So Alex, Alex kenapa nih? Ya, ya.
Signal.
Ya, oke, nggak apa-apa.
Kayaknya sama kayak kita gitu, hujan dikit, slow signal.
Sinyalnya hilang, entah kemana ngumpet.
Atau menurut kalian lebih ada perbedaannya nggak ya, pakai Zoom sama pakai Gmeet? Apa Zoom makan bandwidth lebih gede atau lebih ringkih atau gimana? Atau
kalau aku kalau aku sehari-hari lebih prefer Google Meet sih, Kak.
Oh gitu.
Kalau okay. Google Meet tuh jarang jarang lost signal dan biasanya tuh lebih stabil daripada Zoom. Kalau Zoom tuh kalau kita on cam pasti possible banget untuk hilang-hilangan.
Iya, iya betul ya. Apa dia something happen with my internet connection? Oke, okay, si Alex baru bilang oh. Gitu. Tapi dia jawab Kak? Dia barusan SM apa pakai ya, Telegram, ya. Telegram ya, okay. Chat Telegram. Ya, chat ada mau tanya tadi? Oke, okay, bentar ya saya
teman
jawab dulu ya.
Teman kakak dari mana?
Dari tadi teman kamu nggak dengar tadi dari Rusia. Dari Rusia, namanya kan
tadi putusnya.
Oh
tadi
iya putusnya. Sorry sorry. Oh iya tadi kamu si Ani belum masuk ya tadi. Ya sorry sorry sorry. Namanya Alex, dia guru bahasa Inggris dan guru bahasa Rusia dari Rusia. Jadi bahasa Rusia itu bahasa ibunya bahasa. Tapi dia jago bahasa Inggris juga. Jadi dia ngajar bahasa Inggris di Rusia. Bentar ya saya jawab dulu ya.
Stay in there Kak. Stay di Rusia atau?
Iya, di kan Rusia itu kan besar banget ya, bahkan lebih besar dari Cina yeah. Loh, itunya betul. Ada dan dia itu nggak di ibu kotanya, nggak di Moskow, jadi kayak jauh ke sekitar 2.000 km dari Moskow, jadi kota wow. Kecil, kota kecil. Jadi kalau kita kayak dari sini ke mungkin di Sulawesi ya, Sulawesi atau Papua, jadi dia tinggal di Sulawesi.
Jauh banget
di,
itu.
Nggak tinggal di Jakarta. Oh dia nggak tahu tadi. Tadi kita lupa kasih tahu dia kita tinggal di mana ya. Tapi ya tahulah dia pastilah kita semua tinggal di Jakarta. Oke, ini saya udah bilang kita nunggu. Jadi nggak apa-apa sementara kita nunggu. Kita lanjut aja ya.
Oke.
Okay.
Oke. Okay. Kita masuk ke. Oh, wait sebentar. It's okay. Oke. Oke. Okay. Ini bisa share screen kan ya?
Bisa Kak.
Bisa ya. Oke, okay, mungkin yang pertama harus tadi kan kita merencana mau oke, okay. wait dia bilang dia udah bisa lagi sebentar ya, tapi mesti di invite lagi Kak. Wait. Or something like that. Ini cara invite-nya gimana lagi? So, wait.
Oh iya, yeah, okay. Join dulu.
Oke. Okay. Iya, memang saya juga biasa di sekolah pakai Gmeet dan jarang bermasalah. Ini kalau pakai Zoom kayak ini nih, hilang tuh. Kayak suara saya kalian dengar gak? Atau masih putus-putus?
Kalau suara bakalan lebih jernih sih dibanding kalau kita on cam itu pasti bakalan suka trouble gitu Kak, atau suka gak smooth.
Oke, so berarti mungkin kedepannya bisa jadi masukan juga ya untuk pakai Gmeet ya. Kalau pakai Gmeet,
maaf.
Iya, iya oke.
It's okay.
Okay.
Yes.
It's okay. Alex or Mr. Alex?
No,
Mr.
Alex.
Okay.
Just call him Alex. Biasa kalau budaya asing mah lebih nyantai, lebih enak panggil nama ya.
Yes.
Okay. So Alex, so how about you? Do you use Zoom or Google Meet in your teaching class? Do you have? Can you tell the difference? Yeah. Which one is better?
I never used Google Meetings or Zoom before. I used Skype.
Oh, Skype.
Other Skype. And then platform. There are many schools have their own platform for teaching. You just enter the class, and you don't need to install anything.
Okay. Okay. So, in case of we use Gmeet in the future, will that be okay for you?
I think so, but I never used it. But I think it's okay.
Google Meet, we just use browser, right? We don't even install. We don't need to install anything. Okay. Yeah. So just browser. Oh, maybe.
Tidak yes. Masalah.
Tidak masalah. Okay.
Masalah.
Okay, so let's continue. Kita waktunya jalan terus. Aduh, minta maaf nih. Masih perdana, jadi kayak gini lah ya. Mau lanjut ke cerita gak? Cerita aja kali ya.
Okay, sure, so, please. Yeah.
We'll start with just telling a short story of what we did today. Okay? So, just maybe very short, mungkin minimum like 2-3 kalimat, tapi kalau kalian mau cerita panjang juga enggak apa-apa sih. Ya, 5 menit lah ya. 5. Siapa yang mau mulai duluan nih? Okay, dari saya lagi deh, dari hostnya dulu deh. Atau Pink kan mau mulai? Okay, I will start, okay? As a host, so yeah, it's like I have to be the first just to give example. Okay, so just let's make a short story of what we did today. So I will start first. So today is just another regular day, like routine day for me. This is Thursday, so I have some classes because I am a teacher. So for today, this morning I told I had 3 classes, P3, P5 and P6. So yeah, so
what is P?
P primary. Primary. So P3 primary.
Primary.
Like a grade 3, right? Class 3. Okay, 3. Yeah. So yeah, so I taught until like 2 p.m. and then I prepared for this meeting. And then I fell asleep 7 o'clock. Yeah, so we were supposed to have the meeting 20:30, but 21, like 1 hour late. So yeah, that is my story for today. Okay, next, siapa yang mau? Okay, mungkin kita pakai ini aja kali, alfabet ya, atau gitu. Kayaknya kalau ditanya volunteer agak malu-malu nih, karena.
Yeah,
gue terakhir berarti, nama gue terakhir.
Siapa mau mulai? Oci mau mulai duluan atau Ani mau
yang
mulai?
Yang muda duluan.
Yang muda ya, yang muda silakan. Okay. Duma
Ani. Hari ini kalian apa aja yang dilakukan? Singkat aja, 2 kalimat juga boleh. Sebisa kalian. Kalau mentok pakai bahasa Indonesia dicampur-campur juga nggak apa-apa. Ya, silakan Ani. Atau
dari
tidur,
pagi
tidur seharian.
Sore itu prepare for the exam.
Oh, oke, okay. You're having exam. Oke. Okay. Itu exam-nya kapan? Dari pagi sampai sore prepare exam?
Yes.
So, kapan so when will you have the exam? Kapan kamu akan punya apa melakukan
tomorrow.
Okay. Okay, so the whole day Ani has been preparing for tomorrow exam. So that is Ani's activity for today. Okay, berikutnya next.
Duma.
Duma, ya dari yang muda ya, dari yang muda.
Oh, aku. Hmm. Okay. Pertama bangun-bangun pagi biasanya renungan, terus biasanya juga habis renungan itu olahraga karena hujan, jadi bantuin orang tua bersihin rumah. Terus habis itu mandi, baca novel, habis itu belajar buat masuk PTN, sama belajar juga buat belajar Alkitab, terus habis itu makan, tidur, habis itu baca renungan lagi, kayak gitulah.
Wow, oke, okay, cool. Oke, okay, kalau Duma, so how much can you understand that, Alex?
Do I need belajar dan makan.
Wah,
belajar makan tidur.
Yes.
And then like, yeah, also like praying and then read the Bibles and then that sort of things. So okay. So you can
belajar. Like how to say brain in Bahasa? Brain Bahasa. Indonesianya
berdoa. Can you
berdoa?
Yeah, berdoa. Yes. Doa.
Berdoa.
Do, not do. It's like I heard like do.
Doa. Berdoa.
Yes, berdoa.
Berdoa.
Do so just like cookie.
So the root word doa. So the ber is the prefix.
Doa.
Yeah, berdoa is a noun. So berdoa to make it verb. Berdoa to pray. Okay. Lanjut next is siapa nih? Oci siapa ping kan tuan siapa ya?
Tuan siapa ping?
Gak berani jawab, gue takut kualat.
Bercanda. Ya udah.
Tenang, kita baper, no baper, baper club.
No baper club.
Oke.
Okay. Me first.
Yeah, I know. Okay, Pinkan will be next.
Okay. I start this morning with praying first. For thankful to God like we used to, and during this pandemic I can choose work from home or remote, and I pick remote. Before I go to work, I cook for my mom, and I had meeting with some universities for partnership and picking up my husband at his office, and we came home.
Okay,
as simple as that.
Selesai kerja jam berapa sore ya? Sekitar jam
I talk 3 p.m.
Oke. Okay. Berarti tadi di rumah kan udah dari jam sore.
No, I'm work remotely, Kak.
Oh.
Jadi luar tadi.
Iya, yeah. Tapi tadi kan dijemput Kiki
jemput Kiki.
Oh, iya. Yeah. Maksudnya itu jam berapa?
Balik.
Itu jam berapa?
Oh, at 5 p.m.
5 p.m. Oke.
Okay. So I'm just waiting at the mall nearby.
Okay. Okay. So you pick up your husband, right? So it's not like your husband pick you up.
Woman power. because I drove the car today, so I pick his. I pick him up.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, Pinkan. Yay. Okay. Any question, Alex? it's just regular activity the same for Pinkan. So yeah, go to work and then but biasanya Pinkan yang jemput kalau pulang atau ganti-gantian aja tergantung kondisi aja.
Tergantung kalau siapa yang lagi pengen jemput. Enggak, biasanya Kiki cuma lately I used to drive a car, so I pick him up.
Okay, alright. So lately it is you who picks him up instead of your husband picking you up.
Yes.
Because I don't know, maybe you
just changing the situations.
Okay.
I think.
So. Okay. Next is Ochi.
Okay, my regular activity. In the morning, I like another people. I pray to thankful to God, and I go to work in this day, and I have the some. Tugas apa sih, Kak? From my boss.
Assignment.
I prepare assignment for my boss because I have the I must to present one article I have read and this in this day I am back up my friend's job. I think that's all.
Okay. Temannya Uci kenapa?
Pulang di awal.
Oh, okay.
Beli.
Yes. Okay, so it's also the regular day for Uci. But maybe the difference today because one of her co-worker like went home early, so she has to do her co-worker's job. So
slightly different because berbeda dan biasanya.
Yes. Berbeda dari biasanya.
Dari biasanya.
Yeah. So slightly different today than the regular activity. Oke, mungkin sedikit kalau masukkan thankful itu sebenarnya kata sifat sih. Jadi kalau kalian mau bersyukur to give thanks. Jadi kata kerja to give thanks. Ya, yeah, or okay. to thank God for today or to give thanks to God. So, kalau thankful kata sifat, so we are thankful bla bla bla. Nggak apa-apa ya, masukan yang saya ingat aja. Jadi kadang-kadang kalau ngingat saya koreksi, kalau nggak ingat ya mohon maaf.
Koreksi kalau lu nggak ingat.
Okay, Kak, thank you because we study together in
yes okay ya yeah. Sebenarnya sih kalau ada sih yang bilang sebenarnya nggak harus dikoreksi juga sih, yang penting selama orangnya enjoy bicara itu udah bagus. Jadi saya juga kadang-kadang kalau mau ngoreksi mikir-mikir udahlah nggak usah deh, yang penting iya
tapi nggak pernah tahu salahnya dong.
Nggak, ngoreksinya dengan cara nggak langsung, jadi paling saya ngucapin lagi kalimatnya tapi dengan yang benar gitu. Jadi mungkin dia akan dengar ada versi lain ngucapinnya, mungkin jadi kayak masukan baru gitu. Paling kalau saya sering ulang-ulang dia akan pakai itu aja deh, kayaknya kalau diulang-ulang terus mungkin begitu cara yang benar gitu. Karena seperti itu juga cara orang tua ngajarin anak-anaknya waktu kecil ngomong, dia kan nggak bilang kamu salah ngomong, dia mana ngerti anak 2 tahun 3 tahun dibilang salah ngomong. Dia cuman orang tua akan kasih ngomong terus contoh aja, tapi orang tua ya kasih contoh dengan yang benar. Okay. Tinggal Alex, so it's you are the last one to tell your activity today.
I went to the swimming pool.
Oh really?
You can do it.
Is it
open during this pandemic?
Yes.
Yeah, it's open.
Oh, okay, good.
So if you want to swim, you can go to Russia.
It's a long way. And you
mahal tiket pesawat.
I have one in my apartment.
You can swim and you can play with snow.
Yeah, masih musim dingin. Okay.
So I visited my parents at their house. I worked a little. I had two classes. Played and that's it.
Yes. Okay. Cool.
Okay.
So you just went to the swimming pool or did you swim as well?
Of course I swim.
Oh. Okay.
There is no point going to swimming pool without. Swimming.
No, I mean like you are like accompanying someone.
Oh.
No. Okay.
Yeah, my mother. I met my mother at swimming pool, so we swam together.
Alright. Di Jakarta nggak ada tempat. Nggak ada, jangan kan kolam renang malah udah dari udah setahun lalu tuh kolam renang kadang pakai kali kalau. So Jakarta is one of the worst cities in Indonesia that got hit by the COVID. So it's like public services are closed, right? I mean in term of the swimming pool, I think we don't use swimming pool like since last year for the public facilities.
To be more precise, Jakarta was hit by Indonesian officials, not by COVID. COVID is not very dangerous.
Really? Seriously?
Of course. It's like regular flu.
Okay.
Are you sure?
You can check statistics.
Well, but I don't. Russia also has like big number of. Yeah, I mean. Or maybe the people can heal just like regular flu, you mean?
If you choose any disease, there are many diseases. If you choose any disease and start counting numbers, you can see, oh, so many people die. We need to close everything. But
all right. So maybe because like us, all the governments in the world, they are too paranoid of this.
They have some governments and some big companies try to restrict human rights, try to they have their purpose.
Okay. But I don't know, the death toll among the elderly, like people over 70 years old.
You know, I can tell you the interesting story happened in Africa. There is a country called Tanzania. There were, do you know these tests for COVID?
Oh, right, yeah, yeah.
That country bought some tests and they were checked on human, on goat, animal, goat, and papaya. Papaya fruit. Mm-hmm. All of them showed COVID, goat. Papaya also is with COVID. So the president decided not to buy tests anymore and not to mention COVID. No masks, no clothes. Everything is opened and no masks.
Okay, enough.
So now Russian tourists go to Tanzania, Zanzibar.
Okay.
It's a good business opportunity actually for country, but while other countries are closed.
Yes. So let's have the tourists come to their country, right? Jadi ya seperti itu tuh. Jadi ada beberapa negara yang melihat masalah COVID sih bukan masalah besar. Jadi it's not a big deal, just like regular disease. Ya, tapi ya jadi tergantung dari pemerintahnya sih. It depends on the government. So obviously our government is very strict, right? So it's like Jakarta is like, I think this is ini udah PSBB yang keberapa kali ya?
Sekian kali.
So this is like the third time or the fourth time of the lockdown. So it's like they keep on extending the so 1 month and then extend again. So it's like
extend again.
Yeah.
But my friend, another friend from Jakarta, he went to Bandung
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I think Bandung is also the same, right? I mean, like the
Bandung is red zone, I think.
What?
Red zone. Red zone.
Yeah, the same. Yeah, so Jakarta,
Bandung,
West,
Bogor,
yeah, West Java.
West Java.
That will include Bandung, Bogor. It's like red. So we call it like a red zone because the number of the cases are very high.
Increase.
It spread
not so just the population density.
Yeah.
Yes.
So Tangerang, Bekasi, Depok,
Jabodetabek.
Yes. We call it Jabodetabek. So yeah, that's the acronym Jakarta, Bogor. Jabodetabek. Tangerang, Bekasi. So Jabodetabek. Like Jakarta and the surrounding
just say big areas. Jakarta.
Yeah, big Jakarta. But you already have friends from Depok, right? You said you have friends in Depok. Is it you?
No, they live in Jakarta.
They live in Jakarta, okay. So I myself live in Cikarang, that is in Bekasi area. So all of these friends, they Pinkan, Ochi, Duma, and Ani, they live in Jakarta. So you have friends now more friends in Jakarta. Okay, any more question, guys? Mau nanya tentang
I'm curious apa? About something. Can I ask directly to Alex?
Sure.
You see in Russian it's apa ya ngomongnya? Gue bingung. Gugup. Sorry. Yeah. I'm just curious. Do you wear masker?
No. Now it's 1 month ago.
1 month.
We need to wear mask when we enter the shop or any public place.
Maybe post office. I miss going out without mask.
No mask now. Some people wear masks, but it's not mandatory. If you don't want, don't wear.
Gak disangsi tuh ya, nggak pakai.
There's no government rules about that.
So if you want to wear, you can wear. If you don't want, it's not mandatory.
Maybe I think I fall in love with Russian government.
So here in, especially in Jakarta, it is a mandatory to wear a mask.
Yes.
So it's already the part of the rule, right? So if you don't wear a mask, you are breaking
the rule.
You
can get punishment.
You will get some like fine or like some other punishment.
In winter, if you wear a mask, actually sometimes it's too cold. So wearing mask might be more comfortable for you. Because of the cold,
so not because of the COVID,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's different thing.
Yeah, just to keep you warm. Just to keep you warm.
Yeah. Yeah. So yeah, right. Pinkan, you can start thinking of going to Russia then.
I mean.
You already fall in love with Russian government.
Yeah. Just kidding. I still love Indonesia's government. Nanti di boycott sama Zoom nih.
So by the way, Alex itu 2 hour difference, the time difference. So Alex is like 2 hours behind us. Jadi Alex masih jam setengah sembilan ya. So your time is
30.
But right. In Russia is very very wide, right? So how many time zone in Russia?
11.
11 time zone, seriously? So like if the people live on the one end, like the very east, and then one is on the very west. So the time
when people in the east go to sleep, people in the west wake up.
Seriously? In Indonesia, we
almost.
Only Jadi saking panjangnya, it's very wide, so the time.
Three time zones.
In Indonesia only 3 time zones. So Jakarta is the west.
Papua 2 hours
ahead. Yes, Papua 2 hours ahead. So Papua already what? Friday now? Yeah, already Friday in Papua.
Friday.
Ini Ani sama Duma suaranya mana nih? Si Ani juga.
Baby Ani lost her signal.
Hadir kak.
Oh hadir, iya. Kamu kak, kalau mau ngomong aja, jangan. Ada.
Oke, bahasa Indonesia lagi? Boleh kok Duma.
Oh, ya, nggak apa-apa Dum. Nanti translate. Nggak
ada yang ditanya.
Karena kalau kita pakai bahasa Indonesia, Alex sudah belajar. Jadi ya ini sengaja saya cari teman-teman yang mau belajar bahasa Indonesia. Ya, jadi ya. Jadi kita saling membantu. So, any other questions? Or okay, gimana kalau tentang 1000 kata yang saya sempat share tadi sore? Kira-kira kalian sempat lihat gak tuh?
Lihat doang
sih
ya.
Lihat doang ya. Nggak, minimal yang halaman pertama. Yang halaman pertama dibilang 100 kata pertama itu aja bisa sampai berapa? 30% lebih.
30%
itu dari 25 kata. 100 katanya berapa? 50% loh. Jadi dari satu halaman pertama itu aja tuh udah kalian akan selalu ketemu kata itu. Setengah dari tulisan-tulisan tuh menggunakan kata-kata itu. Ya kebanyakan sih kayak partikel atau ya kata-kata depan, tapi itu sering dipakai sih. Well, anyway, ternyata ini ya, waktu itu cuma ngobrol-ngobrol singkat gini doang, waktunya jalan terus. Ini, tapi nggak apa-apa sih, jadi ini pengalaman pertama kita, jadi mungkin 30 menit sebenarnya waktu yang sangat singkat. Jadi sebenarnya ide-idenya banyak sih, mau games A, games B, mau mungkin bahas sedikit tentang grammar. Tapi mungkin hari ini nggak dulu kali ya, nanti kelamaan sih, karena takes time. Jadi lebih ke kita ngobrol aja. Mm-hmm. Oke, hari ini jadi banyak ngobrol aja. Mungkin ada topik yang mau dibahas, atau ada pertanyaan lagi tadi seperti pingkan, mungkin mau... Can you catch any words, Alex? Like I'm just speaking Indonesian.
Some
like
just separate words. I want to ask, what is there a difference between terakhir and so what's the other word for next?
Berikutnya. Terakhir is the last one. Bika ada mau jawab Pingkan atau Oci? Perbedaan kata terakhir dan berikutnya. Ada mau coba
jawab? Means, okay. Terakhir means the last one, and berikutnya means like the next one or next step maybe, something like that.
So if you have sequence of, if you are explaining about the sequence of thing, so first pertama-tama. First thing, pertama-tama, misalkan apa ya, instruksi apa gitu ya. Mungkin first kayak first, memasak, when you do cooking, right? Ya.
Pertama kali ini ya.
Prepare the ingredients, right? Prepare the ingredients, right? For example, like the thing you do when you make, when you cook something delicious. So first, prepare the material. Next, berikutnya. Pertama-tama siapkan bahan-bahan. Berikutnya apa, Bing? Cuci bahan-bahan.
Cuci. Wash.
Potong-potong.
Washing the vegetables.
Berikutnya. And then kemudian, so you can switch between berikutnya and kemudian. Because yeah, we want to make fair like yeah,
then variety, like
right? Not just like berikutnya, lalu ya.
Yeah.
So you can switch between berikutnya, lalu, kemudian. So
kemudian.
Those have the same meaning, only different words. So variasi.
Kemudian sounds almost like Cambodian.
Like what?
Cambodian.
Cambodia.
Cambodian. Oh, well, Cambodian berarti you skip the. So for kemudian we have kemudian four syllables, right? Cambodia is like Cambo, so it's like Ian. Yeah, almost
Cambodia.
Yeah. But for Indonesian kemudian.
Dian.
So kemudian. Yeah. If you say the ke, it will be very clear, like kemudian. And then last step, terakhir. Yeah, you serve the food, for example, like that. Yeah, Oci mau tambahkan lagi Oci?
Enggak, tadi putus kak. Agak nggak denger gue.
Duma mau nambahkan lagi, tuh Alex nanya tadi itu bedanya kemudian sama terakhir.
Enggak kak.
Enggak.
Kalau Duma belajar juga bedanya kalimat itu apa.
Belajar kata itu apa ya.
Serius gimana? Emang Duma masih belajar bahasa Indonesia gitu?
Enggak kak, itu bercanda. Biar seru aja. Just for fun.
For fun.
Pingkan sih mama.
Biar we didn't fall asleep.
Oke, ada pertanyaan lain nggak? Apa ya? Tadinya sih mau bikin game, tadi kayak misalkan satu kata gitu ya, satu kata atau dari halaman pertama itu kalian pilih satu kata dan buat kalimat seperti itu. Atau ada ide game lagi, saya pilih kata sifat, misalkan kata sifat apa ya hari ini ya, surprise gitu. Ada gak kata, pengalaman yang surprise buat kalian gitu, tapi it will take time. Jadi free talk aja dulu ya hari ini ya, karena
ya.
Jadi ada lagi mau diobrolin gak?
Duma ya dong. Apa emang jobrolin tuh?
Iya. Apa Duma mau ngambil apa tadi tuh? Mau ngambil major apa rencananya kalau kuliah? Bahasa Rusia Raka. Mungkin?
Perlu waktu.
Perlu waktu. Take time.
Perlu waktu.
Long time.
So any other, how about you Alex? Do you have any other questions?
Yeah. How about maybe everybody can say what is the most favorite place in Indonesia you have ever been to?
Okay.
What is the most beautiful?
Beautiful.
Yeah. Like the like the most beautiful, like, that you can think of, or the most memorable, yang paling
memorable. Yeah. Actually, your experience.
Yeah, yang paling berkesan. Tuh. Ngerti pertanyaannya enggak dari Alex? Tempat
ngerti dulu.
Tempat yang paling berkesan yang pernah kalian kunjungi, yang pernah kalian kunjungi ya, yang bisa
in
jadi
Indonesia, right?
Indonesia, yes.
Oke. Okay. Coach silakan.
Oh, boleh juga luar negeri, boleh. Me. So, okay. any place within Indonesia or abroad? Ayo, siapa duluan?
In Indonesia.
Indonesia? Oke, oke. Okay. In Indonesia.
Okay. I think in Bali.
Bali, oke.
Okay. Yes, Bali have many beautiful place. Like, ini apa sih? Oh, ya. Kuta Beach.
Beach, ya, yeah, beach.
Yes, Kuta Beach. But I'm... gue bukan tipe yang suka jalan-jalan sih, gue tipe orang rumahan, jadi setahu gue udah kecil gue balik dong yang bagus.
Oke, so yeah, well actually that's quite correct, right? So Bali has many beautiful places.
Bali and Jogja maybe ya?
Okay, Bali and Jogja. Okay.
Jogja.
Oke. Oke, Pingkan?
Oke. Just like last year before pandemic hit us, I visit Bali and it's my favorite destination for holiday and refreshing. I love visiting the beach club. Oh, expensive lifestyle. No. just refresh our minds because we have a lot of stress because of works. So me and my husband choose Bali for getting refreshed because the atmosphere in there so relaxing and make us happy and peaceful, I think.
Okay.
And so,
I love waktu nyepi kali ya.
Enggak, itu waktu akhir tahun. Jadi
wah, ya tahun kira lagi
pasti hektik banget. Cuma tetap senang aja karena Bali not just Kuta, but they also have Ubud, if you know.
Yes.
Ubud, Legian Street. And Ubud itu kalau nggak salah lebih peaceful sih daripada Denpasar atau Kutanya sendiri karena they have more green, greeny things like trees, village, something like that. Terus and I love visit Malaysia because they have a lot of food. I love to eating actually. Yeah, like that.
Okay, so Ubud is like puncak, what?
Yeah, kayak kebun teh kak.
Yeah, it's like you are going up the higher ground, like up to the hills or mountains.
Like hills, I think.
Hills, okay. But we're like going up, right? Like if you go to the center of the Bali, it's like you will go to higher part, right? And then you will,
yes.
And then like there's a Gunung Agung, right? The Mount Agung.
Yeah.
Yes.
Correct.
Okay. So Ubud, yeah. So actually the same thing. So I prefer go to mountains. So I don't know. I think for me mountain is like a more peaceful place than going to the beach. So I prefer go to the mountain. So my favorite place, like one of my favorite places is in Lembang, Bandung. So Bandung is like the higher ground, right? Yeah. So it's like it's very peaceful, and then the scenery is very beautiful. So that's like the one of the memorable place for me, Lembang, Bandung. So in Bandung, yeah.
Lembang.
In Lembang, right? So I don't know. Is Lembang and Bandung dekat gak sih? Saya lupa lagi deh.
1 hour, Kak.
1 hour. Okay, so Lembang is 1 hour from Bandung. Lebih tinggi ke Lembang ya? Kalau ke Lembang kayaknya ke atas ya?
Ya.
Yeah. Iya, yeah, so
dan,
it's like
Lembang got temperaturnya dingin banget.
Iya, yeah, so it's quite cold.
Jadi suhunya
yes.
Tidak sama dengan Bandung.
Yeah, yeah. My friend cold. Told me it's quite cold.
Yeah, yeah, so in Lembang. So yeah. It's very peaceful, so I remember like the scenery is very beautiful. Like we can look at the hills, and then the place also is very very cool, very very memorable for me. So Bandung Lembang. Well,
Bali. Did you already go to Kawah Putih, Kak?
Kawah
Putih not yet.
Did you already to Kawah Putih at
in
Lembang?
In Lembang, no, not yet. Is it also beautiful?
It's more peaceful.
Oh really? Okay, yes. So okay, I will take a note of that.
Recommended.
Please. Yeah. Okay. Duma, berikutnya tempat yang paling berkesan yang pernah kamu kunjungi di Indonesia atau di luar boleh?
Dufan.
Bukan baru mau jawab. Aku nggak pernah kunjungi tempat ini, cuman.
Ya,
aku nggak pernah kunjungi tempat ini, tapi pengen di Indonesia.
Oh,
namanya Papua tempatnya.
Papua.
Iya.
Raja Ampat.
Oh. Iya.
Oh, Raja Ampat.
Gitu kan.
Oh, oke. Okay. Kamu korban ini kayaknya korban iklan deh. Atau Enggak, tapi Raja Ampat memang ini sih, kayaknya bagus. Indah banget ya, dari teman-teman yang udah pernah kesana juga bilang.
Foto-fotonya. Iya, ditambah filter-filter kak, kayaknya makin indah. Coba-coba dulu ke ini, ke Kepulauan Seribu, kurang lebih sama.
Oh gitu? Ya, Pulau Seribu
sama
juga
pantainya okay sih.
Iya, yeah, so Raja Ampat in Papua, that is for Duma.
Duma.
So yeah, because we are archipelago, right? Like we have 17,000 islands.
So can you say like gag buruk, like not bad?
Not bad, nggak buruk. Gag
buruk.
Nggak apa ya? Not bad apa bahasa Indonesianya ya? Nggak jelek ya?
Tidak jelek.
Iya, nggak buruk. Nggak buruk. Kayaknya jarang yang orang ngomong nggak buruk ya.
Iya.
Kalau
bagus mungkin.
Nggak baik biasanya.
Nggak baik.
Not bad kalau
baik biasanya. Nggak jelek ya?
Nggak jelek biasanya.
Nggak jelek-jelek amat lah. Not bad lah.
Jelek amat.
Not bad.
Biasa ngomong.
Iya, pingin.
We used to talk, atau we used to say like, nggak jelek-jelek amat lah gitu.
Nggak jelek-jelek.
Campur Betawi.
Iya, nggak jelek-jelek amat. Not bad. Nggak jelek-jelek amat. So four words, nggak jelek-jelek is like we make it like double, nggak jelek-jelek amat. It's like not too bad. So nggak jelek-jelek amat.
Campur Betawi ya.
Tidak,
yeah. Campur Betawi.
Tidak terlalu buruk.
Yes. Not too bad. Yeah. So, yeah. Okay.
Tidak terlalu buruk.
Terlalu is too. Not too bad.
Too.
Formally you can say that.
Yeah, formally. So yeah.
Formally.
If you use the slang word, nggak jelek-jelek amat lah.
Yeah.
So
Betawi language.
Yeah. So the young people in Jakarta, we got influenced a lot with this local people Betawi. So most of the words we use is influenced by the Betawi words. Betawi. So this like the one of the local. One of the local people in Jakarta.
Betawi.
So how to say one more time? You can send me to Telegram.
Enggak jelek-jelek amat.
Jelek amat.
Enggak, you know ga, right? GA or GAK. Enggak jelek-jelek amat. So four words, enggak jelek-jelek amat. Enggak jelek-jelek amat. Says so not too bad.
Four words.
Yes.
Four words. For two words.
Two words.
Okay guys, mungkin untuk hari ini kayaknya sudah cukup ya. Udah malam juga di sini. So what do you think? 30 menit is it too short? Like yeah, if we talk, it's like the time flies, right?
Yeah. Maybe yeah. It's time to say to wrap
Text
it up.
Life.
Yeah.
Yes, okay, jadi
that's
untuk
good
hari
for the first.
Yes, for the first time this is already great, so I want to thank everyone that you guys have joined this first meeting, and the plan is we are going to have this like once a week or once every 2 weeks, so depending on our busyness, right? So maybe we can be busy. So this is going to be a regular meeting. So I will let you know when we can meet in the next meeting. So I want to thank everyone who has joined our meeting. Yang lain ada yang mau disampaikan? Pingkan, Alex, Ochi, ada yang Duma, ada yang mau anything you want to say before we close?
This is new experience to me, and I feel so happy and blessed can meet Alex as my new friends. Thank you so much for your time, and hopefully we can talk together again.
Okay. Ochi?
I think same from Pingkan. Thank you for the new experience, and thank you for Alex. Maybe we gonna more fun for more meeting, so more lebih tambah lagi anggotanya.
Iya.
Yes, we should.
Yes.
Tapi iya,
karena banyak anggotanya.
Saya pikir kalau banyak nanti
pasti
waktunya pasti waktu iya nggak sih, saya kasihan kalau nanti nggak ada yang nggak ngomong gitu, kalau kebanyakan apa nggak apa-apa ya, cuman dengar aja gitu kan, biasanya kan mau semuanya dikasih ya,
mungkin bisa satu ruangan berapa orang gitu. Jadi join.
Oke. Good.
Kalau enggak nggak apa-apa sih kak, kalau ada yang join juga tapi nggak ngomong, they still can watch us right, and mungkin mereka bisa belajar dulu, baru nanti mungkin untuk speakersnya bisa atau yang ngomong itu bisa digilir gitu.
Okay, thank you Pink.
Okay,
Duma ada yang mau diomongin? Duma?
Gak ada.
Malu-malu dong Duma.
Malu-malu Duma.
Masih baru soalnya.
Gak apa-apa.
Okay.
Alex, anything to say before we close?
Oh yeah, I'm also happy to meet all of you.
Mm-hmm, same here.
Thank you for teaching me Bahasa Indonesia. Bahasa Gaul and all other bahasas.
So is it okay for you?
Forget nggak jelek-jelek amat ya.
the word for today for you nggak jelek-jelek amat. Not too bad. Nggak jelek-jelek amat.
Nggak jelek-jelek.
Amat. A-M-A-T in bahasa Indonesia. Amat. Yes, nggak jelek-jelek amat.
Nggak jelek-jelek amat.
Yes, see? Yeah. So Russian tongue is very good to speak good Indonesian word.
Indonesia.
Yeah, different with the English native speaker is like they, because they have different sound in the alphabets, right? So we'll have like the, so yeah.
So you already very skillful. You can speak Russian with ease.
Really?
Teach me, please.
You know a lot of words already, like office, kontora, kelas.
Okay. Mungkin yang lain kalau kantor. Mulai berpikir belajar bahasa Rusia, boleh mulai dibuka-buka bukunya. Download.
Sometimes I learn Russian language from Netflix. Because they have original subtitles and movies from Russian about politics, I think, something like that. But they didn't have subtitle of English or Indonesia, just the original one.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Jadi udah mulai dengar ininya ya, kata-kata Rusianya ya.
Rusianya.
Iya, yeah, sedikit-sedikit. tetap baca subtitle di bawahnya kok.
But you know, for example, some words are quite kind of funny, like chuma.
Chuma.
Chuma. In Russian, it's Robert, do you know the disease plague? Very serious disease plague.
Like. Okay.
PLAGUE. Plague.
Yeah, plague.
In Russian, it's called chuma.
But that's the plague or the name of the disease?
The name of the disease plague in English. In Russian, it's chuma.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Jadi chuma itu kalau di bahasa Rusia tuh artinya kayak penyakit yang sangat berbahaya, yang kayak bisa. Ya bisa jadi memakan banyak korban, menyebar dengan cepat, plague. Ya jadi kalau in Indonesia cuma is like only cuma apa kita biasanya ngomong apa ya
cuma is hanya. for free.
Yeah, if hanya. You use it like yeah hanya. Cuma is hanya only, but if you use it like cuma that has different meaning. Cuma is free. This is free. Ini cuma gratis. We also have gratis.
Gratis
and cuma is the same. So. Yep. Okay, so yeah, we will meet again next time.
Terima kasih banyak.
Terima kasih semuanya.
Terima kasih.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye-bye, selamat malam. Sampai
jumpa lagi.
Terima kasih.
Sampai jumpa lagi, Alex. Sampai jumpa semuanya.
Sampai jumpa, bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.